Once upon a time, there was a small farm school nestled in one of the thousand valleys of the Comus Highlands. The students of the school came from the surrounding farms, but because it was too far for the children to walk home each afternoon, they lived in the school village with their teachers. Life at the school was peaceful. Teachers and students worked together. They respected and cared for one another. Yes, every day was very peaceful. Every day, that is, until the day that everything changed. That was the day that two new students arrived at the school, Ashley and Wesley. The two were instant friends, and pretty soon no one could remember ever seeing Ashley without Wesley, or Wesley without Ashley. They both liked soccer, running, and playing cards. But the things they loved most were playing tricks and making mischief. And the people they most loved to play their tricks on were, well, of course, the teachers themselves.
Chocolate na.
This was only one of the many tricks and pranks the boys were famous for. But this was not over quite yet. And as it happens, this is where our story begins.
Oh, didn't I get out of Wesley?
A really nasty idea came to Wesley's mind. They would replace the chocolates they had just eaten with an old and dry cow dung. Then they would put the box back and see what happened next.
Oh, Jinko Sensei! How is I taking Musi Tamaha? I says King Uncle Sira Musa, two coroner requests on me had to say.
Ashley and Wesley were not finished with their tour of mischief for this day. They were going to push their mischief to the limit. In fact, way beyond the limit this time.
Fatni.
Ek kan dit nie meer vat nie.
Wat gebeur, liefling?
Wat? Jy vra wat het gebeur?
Dieselfde ding wat elke keer gebeur, want jy laat dit toe. Die skool was dal en rustig, totdat Isley en Wesley opgedag het. Hulle het elke dag 'n nuwe stootstreep. Kyk wat die keer gebeur.
Beesmus, kan dit wees?
Ja, ek het dit amper geëet. Jy moet iets doen, dinge het nie so voorgaan nie.
Ek probeer, skatjebol, ek probeer alles wat ek kan. Ek stuur hulle vroeg bed toe, ek stuur hulle vir detentie, alles wat ek in die vermoe kan doen.
Ek weet nie, maar jy moet nou aan iets doen. Of...
Wat gemak vandag.
Kom eens om. Wesley. Wesley, kan jy vandag? Waar is jy? Kom eens om. Wat vir? Wat ek gaan gemak. Kom, vandag sien jy wat ek gaan doen aan julle. Julle klein vandag. Kom.
Woda, ai. Kom eens.
Ja, jy wat vir? Ja, man, dit reën vandag. Stouters. Kyk wat het gebeur.
Ja, kom eens om, kyk wat gebeur. Ja,
julle twee. Kom julle vandag, kyk wat het gebeur.
Wesley.
Vandag, as jy hulle in die hande kry, ek draai hulle sy nek om, vandag. Twee klein blik skorreltjies. Stouterts! Yes! Ja, nou, twee klein blik skorreltjies, ek het hulle lang gesoek. Wesley, Isley, ek wil vir julle vandag 'n les leer. Wat julle gedoen het was baie verkeerd. Julle is gewoond om vir mense 'n streep te trek, om vir mense stout te maak. En vandag sal julle sien wat dit beteken om op 'n eerlike manier iets reg te doen. Julle gaan daardie sportveld vir ons mooi skoon maak. Die klippe uitgooi, die bordels uitgooi. Ons het volgende week Saterdag groot atletiek en dit sal julle se les wees om nooit weer vir iemand 'n streep te trek nie, om nooit weer stout te wees nie. Begin onmiddellik daarmee nou. Baie dankie. Baie dankie, Emmy. Dit lyk lekker.
Alba. Wat het dan daar gebeur?
Wat het kan wel kyk hoe kom dit toe wou ook.
En ek hou hier nog steeds op.
Dit sou iets gedoen het. Kwaal gee. Dit is hier die ander gang.
Julle twee, julle moet nog werk, julle moet klaar maak. Hier kom ek, ek hoor ek haar.
Oh, meneer Barris!
Jo,
help
hem! Jan, help hem! Sorry. Kijk de auto's naar jou, in de auto's. Eetje nog wat, is zo wat. Eetje. Kijk dat je gered maar op aan haar park zit, hè? Ga park zijn nou, oké.
Maar jy moet die skoene net hier stof, laat ons ook die kar toemaak die deur nie. So meneer, is daar vir ons
miskien
iets wat
u
vir ons
kan
help meneer,
asseblief. Hou die kar. Kom sukkel kar. Nou maar. Wat jy nou aan doen? Hoe kan jy dit nie maar doen? Kom maar.
Oké, ik zal de meneer opmaken, nee.
Ja, maar in deze dag is het lekker goed voor jou.
Oké, dank je, meneer.
Je kan maar daar horen.
Oh, dank je, nee, dank je, meneer.
Ja, ik heb voor jou lekker goed voor je school gaan gebruiken.
Baie dank je, meneer. Ja. Baie dank je. Baie dat je voor onze school zo mooi helpt, nee.
Ja.
Baie, meneer. Baie dank je, meneer. Maar ik kan even aangaan.
Ja, ja.
Sorry, sorry. Dank je, toch.
The boys had reached the point where they were not willing to return back to their life of tricks. But that way of thinking didn't last very long. Suddenly a wonderful idea came to them. Well, at least they thought it was a wonderful idea. Before they set out on their search for the moon, they decided to steal bread for the journey. They didn't care that their village was a poor one, and that the stolen bread would mean hunger for their friends and teachers.
Come here. I have to go here.
tjena kom gogo.
The big world they were going to conquer lay in front of them. But this world was so big that as they traveled, they soon felt tired and weary, and not so happy anymore. They say you can't get fat on stolen food. Well, at least this was the first thing that the boys learned on their journey. The bread and beans they had so unscrupulously stolen had turned into a brick and some stones. Now, if you think that they learned something from this, you are deeply mistaken. In fact, Ashley and Wesley quickly regained their spirit and went on in search of more adventure. Was this the first time that the boys felt there was still a lot they needed to learn to survive on their own? Well, perhaps so. And even then, they surely didn't understand it very clearly yet. Even if their empty bellies were aching with hunger, they were full of cheer, and their spirit was strong. Still, they needed some kind of miracle now if they were not going to starve. And, well, this miracle was just about to happen.
You should gather some wood.
Yes.
The hunger they were feeling made them ready to learn their next important lesson. You need to work first to earn your meal.
We did part here.
The two boys learned this lesson quite well and were happy to get the reward. They stuffed their empty bellies with food until they could not move anymore. So, did they really learn their lesson this time? We hope so. The world seemed to be much more friendly with a full belly, but their journey to find the moon hadn't come to an end yet. On this journey, it was their destiny to learn much, much more. But this one was an important lesson for our two boys. For the first time, they saw that it is a pleasure to share what you have.
Who are you? I can hear you. Tell me who you are.
We are Wesley and Ashley, two boys from the farm.
Wesley and Ashley, those are nice names. My name is Verona. I am also from the farm.
You are the one.
Oh, I'll be grateful to have some.
So what are you doing here?
I'm trying to get to the other side to get some medicine for my mother.
That is a boat. We will take you there.
I'll be so grateful.
They were proud to help such a beautiful girl, and maybe this was the point where they truly started to realize that there is so much more to life than stealing and making mischief.
Stop! Where is my hat? I must have dropped it!
Just keep moving, you old fat! You'd lose your head if it wasn't screwed on so tight!
Would both of you dummies just shut up? We will never make it if you keep at each other! Who are you calling a dummy? You fat cow? I'm not fat! This is mostly muscles! Am I right, Silent Snake?
Take a look at yourself! There are no muscles, just fat, which is always slowing us down.
Oh, so now I'm slowing us down? What about two of you last night, partying the whole night through, that we overslept this morning and made us late for the meeting with Slow Stone?
Oh, yeah? Well.
Okay, that's enough. Pretty soon we will have plenty of reason to celebrate.
Now that we've got the moon and we are stinking rich.
But now we must concentrate on finding our way through the valley before it gets dark.
So take a look at the map.
You were the last one to have the map. Where is it? I did not have it! Oh, wait! Wait! No! 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 What? It was in my hat!
Wesley, how did you get out of the way? How did you get
Kore roper kumer mepsa.
Ete, sakang basi ngari ng kabara si uwaro guge. Ay, tama, kabin ngadi. Ano si kamgo na bawo sining kri? Di sakang kawang ngari wa, sinin bawo na i. Sinin bawo kri, kinilay na bawo wa, kinin kumaw i, kinilay na bawo i. Di kama basi ngari, sinin kawang ta, kisinin amahu.
Congo.
So there it was. The boys had nearly forgotten the real purpose of their journey, and now they learned that their moon had already been stolen. With the map in hand, the plan didn't seem so difficult for our boys, so they set out hoping for the best.
It's about time you got here. What took you so long? I should have known better than to leave a bunch of idiots to do their job.
My shoulders are killing me.
After a few hours of walking, they came to the place where, well, according to the map, the robbers would be hiding.
Who did it? Come on, fast out!
What?
I win!
My left foot, you win? You cheated!
Who are you calling a cheater?
You cheated! You've got 5 aces over there!
That's not cheating! That's pure good luck!
Would you all just stop? You're just like a bunch of chickens, you know? Just punting each other all day. We never should have come here. And we know it all! This place is haunted! We will never make it alive tonight.
What zombie? What is he talking about?
What are you two going on about? I'm with Slim Sim. What's the big deal? Like we haven't all been disposed to a few people here and there? We are robbers, and that's part of the job. I, for one, have eaten a half dozen small children in my day.
The boys realized that they had met the most ferocious robbers there ever were on this planet. And what more, they realized what a catastrophe it would be if the moon did not return to where it belongs.
What is he talking about?
They say his mother cried so loud, so hard, and for so long that the boy even heard it after he was dead and underwater.
They say he just rose up and followed her call. The valley is so deep its walls caught the echo of his mother's cries. And now they say he wanders here every night, still listening to her cries, looking and always looking.
Let all of us just go to sleep and have some sweet dreams about what we can do when moon is not shining anymore.
It's going to be a robber's paradise without the stupid moon up in the sky.
We can rob all farms without being noticed.
Yeah, remember the school we've passed? We can rob everything from them.
Kill everyone.
And eat all children.
Yeah!
Saking asti basi, tugu ni kuara na kam, tirami rover kuge. Nisi kangen apa di? Ikan mata apa orang ini? Hey, apa sih dia umur kau? Anja mai, kau rover kau apa? Oleh aku history sa. Masih ramu sen. Hey, nice to meet you. I'm
What could they do? For the first time, their skill at playing pranks could save the world. They quickly made their decision. One more prank was needed.
Rising?
It's the zombie boy!
This was the biggest adventure of their life. In fact, they would rarely tell this story later because it was just so incredible. But now, they were two new boys. They were very, very happy. And I don't need to add that the moon was also happy, shining in the sky high above. And the moon, which had been crying hard when it was captured, left the boys one beautiful present, a silver tear. The boys decided to travel back home. Remember, they were very good and brave boys now. But there was still one thing that really troubled them. They had stolen the bread. And how could they come back without making it up somehow? Just then they saw the same old woman who had fed them, and they knew that she would help them once again.
kere dui pere na. Dui pere ba kam yeke ngari ai.
Hello.
Hello. You want the bread?
Yes.
You must give me the most precious thing you have.
I got this from the moon.
Where is the bag for your bread?
Thanks.
Wesley, ego maske.
In tu comare.
So Ashley and Wesley returned to their village. But if you think that they were welcomed as what they were, two little heroes, you are very much mistaken. In fact, not only were they punished for running away, stealing bread, stealing the horses, and then stealing even more bread, nobody wanted to believe the boy's wonderful story. As time went by, the villagers couldn't help but notice how much the boys had changed. They were lovely, helpful boys. And soon, everybody in the village had forgiven them for all their mischief and pranks. But every now and then, when the sky is just right and the villagers are fast asleep, the two boys sneak out of town once again. They travel through the darkness to a nearby hill. And once there, they dance in the shimmering light of the moon.